12 noon, April 25th, 2010, and the fifth session between Mr. Olurofe and Mrs. Koriko Ehoros with Black Commences.
You once told me that the only planet fire can burn is Earth. Other planets don't have sufficient oxygen. I find that funny because I've always wondered what hell feels like on other planets. I hated you. Just the way I hated all men. There was something in the way you looked at me. Like you needed saving. You talked to me different. You held me different. You made me feel this weird tingling feeling, and that made me so uncomfortable with myself. I don't take your patience for granted, but I'm trying really hard to stop.
Well, this is harder than I thought. You say that you hate them, but you're comfortably screwing around like you did the last one.
You don't know that.
Maybe I don't. Maybe I do. But that does not change the fact that you slept with six other men before this potential one since our marriage.
No, that is not entirely true.
You see, there is only so much that a man can handle. Who is he? I said, who is he?
Ofe, I would never cheat on you. I don't love them. I don't love him. He's just...
Do not lie to me.
And don't be an obsessive, compulsive narcissist.
I got to understand that you both decided to take breaks from the sessions in the rage room. But asking to unexpectedly see me, frankly speaking, it's quite worrisome. I had to leave some things unattended just to be here with you guys. Clearly, something is wrong, but none of you seem to want to say anything about it. So what's going on? Silence isn't helping.
Mr. and Mrs. Oswald Black, what is happening?
Calling you here was actually his idea, not mine. I mean, he woke me up in the middle of the night and he didn't tell me anything, and he has not even spoken to me since then. He's the one that has something to say, not me.
Mr. Olurofe, please, can you talk to us? I mean, things have gotten better between you two since you started the rage room therapy. But this mood, this act, it's a development I don't seem to understand. Please just enlighten us. What's going on? If you don't want to say something to me, can you at least say something to your wife? Mr. Olurofe.
I am not a narcissist.
Ha 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 ha! You're not. Babe, make sure you don't sleep past 9 a.m. Babe, make sure you wash your hands when you get back.
Stop.
Babe, make sure you brush your teeth by 6 a.m.
Stop.
Make sure you don't stare at your phone too much.
Stop.
Switch on your GPS. Oh my! Ah! Ah!
Stop.
I'm sick of you.
Stop. Stop, Rico.
With you, it's always the rules. Rules, rules, rules. Like I'm tired.
Stop.
You know what? I'm tired. I'm tired of you always whining that I am the problem. And you clearly have a big problem of your own.
I said stop! I didn't say that.
You didn't have to. Mr. Perfectionist. Yes, yes, you're a bone specialist. So what? I should kill myself.
Oriko, you do not understand.
What do you want from
me? I don't want to lose you.
Monitoring my every movement won't keep me either.
I'm only trying to protect you.
Protect?
Yes.
I don't need your protection. You always try to control. Controlling everything. Eh? You cannot control everything.
Yes, I can. If I properly kept those explosives after the experiment, she would still be alive. Everybody says that a fire outbreak caused the explosion. But that's not true. I am responsible for the deaths of those people. I am responsible for my mom.
Shh. Hey. Listen to me, you did not do that.
I did.
Look at me. You did not. That Ikeja accident, it's not your fault, okay? It's not. It's okay. I still love you, Ofe. I do.
Okay. I love you too. Pudding.
Said what?
That is what my wife calls him.
Okay.
Pudding! I thought you were good. I thought you loved me. I read all the messages on your phone. It all makes sense now.
Okay.
You always had eyes for him. It's why you suggested that you be a therapist.
Interesting. Joe!
Joe, come on, wake up! Joe! Oh my god! Joe,
please! What have you done?
Nothing more than what you did.
Oh my god! Joe! Oh my god! Do something! Joe!
I gave him naphthalene and methylcarbamate in school. Listen. Wait. First, you must confess your love for
him. You psychotic twit! I did not fuck him! I did not! Isn't that not what you wanted? Not the fuck on that man!
But do you love him?
Yes.
home. Trouble physically.
How do I look?
Love me.
So how do I look, buddy? Am I Dr. Joga enough for you?
This is the story of two lovers. It was just them against the world. But like every love story, this one was flawed too. Two imperfect people, too perfect in the eyes of people. A facade they try to keep up. No giving up was their worst word to try to make it work. Is that even enough? I was never enough for you.
Never, never, never.
You always wanted.